Okay, in today's video, I want to show you how to make monthly, yearly, or quarterly reports using pivot tables in Microsoft Excel. First of all, the data has to look like it does in the screen here. It's very important that your field names are on the first row, then each row after that is a different record, and each column is a different field. Now, notice column A is a date field, and every single transaction, every single field is a date type of field within that entire column. Okay, that's really important that data would be consistently dates for this exercise to work. Let's make a pivot table. So I'm going to click on cell A1, and I'm going to pick on the insert menu up top, insert, and over here I'm going to pick on pivot table, and then I'm going to pick on pivot table again. Now on this screen, you hardly have to change anything because usually it's going to pick the proper range for you. In this case, it did. And then I'm going to put the pivot table on a new worksheet. So we'll click on OK. Okay, now here we are in this screen where we're going to build the pivot table. First of all, let's say I wanted it by destination. I'm going to pull the destination down into the row label. And you can see each different destination became a different row in the pivot table. Now, the column label normally could be any other field. For example, if I wanted to be a crosstab between the destination and the office field, then I would use the office field as my column label, and you can see how it would come out. We have a cross-reference by destination and then by office. I'm going to move the office back up from the column field, however. If you want it by date, then you're going to pick in the date field. I'm going to pick up date and move it in the column heading. Now you can see that we have it by each individual day, but very soon I'll show you how to do it by month, quarter, and by year. Now, if you want numbers in your pivot table, you'll pick some kind of number field and move that into the values area. So I'll pick up total and move it into the values area. And now we actually have a cross-reference summary report by destination and by individual day. Now, let me show you how you do it by month and by quarter and by year. I'm going to right-click on this first date right here, and I'm going to pick on group. Now, again, this only works if that field had been completely dates all the way through the column. First of all, I can pick a different date range. Let's say you want it last week or last month or whatever the date range would be. You can change that here. Now, notice down here, if it were a time field, I can summarize it by second, minute, or hour. But since it's a date field, I can do it by day, month, quarter, or year. Month is already chosen for me. I'm going to click on OK. And just like that, now we have it summarized by month. Watch how we did that again. I'm going to right-click on Gen. I'm going to go back to Group. Notice how you really can do it by day, month, quarter, or year. Let's do year this time. And now it's summarized by year. Now, notice how I only have 1999, 2008, and 2011 because that's all the data that I have in my original spreadsheet. If I had the other years, they'd be listed there as well. Now, let's say you wanted it by year and by month at the same time. I'm going to right-click on 1999. I'm going to pick on group. Now, you can pick more than one of these, as many as you wanted to, as a matter of fact. So I'm going to pick on month and year at the same time. I'll click on OK. And now notice what we have it broken down first by year and then by month within the year. And then I would probably do one more step after that. I would right click on 1999 and then pick on subtotal years. And here we are just a few minutes later, and we already have a summary report by destination, by individual month, and then the whole year is summarized as well. And we have just a great report after a few minutes. Now, what if you show this to your boss or your department head, and they say, "Well, this is a great report, but can you give me the same report by office as well?" So look what I'm going to do. I'm going to pick up destination from the row label and then drop that back to the fields, and then pick up the office field and drag it into the row label. And now I have the same exact report by office rather than by destination. What if I wanted it by commission? I'm going to pick up office and move it back up here. I'll pick up commission and move that to the row label. So once I have this set up, I can move any field down into the row label to get a summary by month and then by year for that field. So pretty quickly, we were able to get a tremendous report that summarizes by month, quarter, and year in an Excel pivot table.